Hello YouTube, and welcome back to my channel. Who said I was an angel? So today is New Year's Eve, and this is my last video of 2018. So as always, well, I mean, this is only the second time I'm doing this, but like, as usual, this is gonna be a Q&A. So my friends and I guess subscribers sent me questions on Snapchat. So I'm just gonna answer most of them, like eight to nine, and I'll give my honest answers. Hopefully we don't get too deep because some of these might make me a little sad, but I'm just gonna answer them in order. So in the order I receive, that's how I'm answering. So yeah, let's get into it. So the first question is, what's one thing that you did in 2018 that you won't do in 2019? And that is let people use and abuse me. When I tell you guys, in 2017, I had a situation where I spent a lot of money on this person and they were no longer in my life. And I said I would not do that in 2018. Then 2018, just recently, I just found out somebody dropped me, and that person, I spent a lot of money on them this year. And not just that, that's just a money thing, but using and abusing someone could be like, it can have nothing to do with money, it can be your time. So like, that money thing made me upset, but also there's people this year who also like use and abuse my time. So hopefully 2019 will be the year that I will stop, because 2017 I said I would stop in 2018, and look at me now. I lost so much. Between 2017 to 2018, I spent so much money and time on people who ended up dropping me, or I had to drop them because they were bad for like my mental health. So the one thing I would not do next year is let people use and abuse me. Thank you, next question. The next question was, what was your top three highlights of 2018? So, okay, actually, let me do an order. Number one thing, I seen Justin Timberlake in concert. Oh my gosh, everyone's like, Charlotte, I didn't imagine like this being like that big of a thing for you. And I'm like, how many times have I said Justin Timberlake is my idol, my everything, like my favorite human being, my favorite artist on the planet? And the Man of the Woods album was so good live, and then hearing all the throwbacks was like, oh. So just seeing Justin Timberlake, especially at a time where I was like going through the most, like I needed that so much. And like, I will forever, like anytime somebody asks me like, how was your year? I'm like, trash, but seeing Justin Timberlake was amazing. That's always my answer I've been saying like the past week. And then the second thing was traveling to New York as a whole. I'm not just gonna say Jingle Ball, because the day before that I went sightseeing, so like the whole trip was the second favorite highlight of the year. And my third highlight would be going to Disney World. I don't know which trip was more fun, the May or the June one, but just Disney World in general, the fact that I got to go this year twice. That was my third highlight of 2018. And then this person sent me a second question. They said, what concert are you looking forward to attend? She didn't say next year, but I'm assuming she meant next year. And that would be Ariana, but not at the Miami show, at the Madison Square Garden show. Like, I'm excited for the Miami, but I've seen her in Miami twice. I'm excited to actually see her in the biggest arena in the world, Madison Square Garden, and my favorite city in the United States, New York. So I'm so excited for that. That's gonna be June 18th, I believe, so this summer. So I'm excited. That's the concert I'm excited for next year. Okay, this person asked me, what's my favorite concert I've been to this year? A lot of people would not believe me, but Justin Timberlake literally was my favorite concert this year. Like, everyone's like, girl, Beyonce, but I'm like, love Beyonce, but like, she's number two. Like, Justin Timberlake, number one. The reason why Justin Timberlake was my favorite concert this year is because his like tour, like as a whole, was so well thought out, well planned. Like, it was so like well put together, and like the set list was amazing, and I loved how like his stage ran through the whole floor, so it didn't matter where you stood, you had a good view. And even though I didn't get a selfie, I love the fact that he took fans' phones like the entire tour and took pictures with them. And the best part was like, he made the Man of the Woods, he brought that inside the arena. And Man of the Woods, like you think of outside, like in the woods, outdoors, he brought the outdoors inside, and I just thought that was like genius. So like, that would be my favorite concert of 2018, but close second would be Drake or Beyonce. Those were like amazing. But like Justin Timberlake, I don't know, I think it just holds him dear to my heart, because like, I was waiting for this for so long. So that's why I would put this over Beyonce. But if I hadn't seen Justin this year, Beyonce would probably be like my favorite, you know? Next question is favorite meet and greet experience of the year. It has to be Sabrina Carpenter because this was my second time meeting her, but I was so much more like relaxed and I talked, if you remember me talking about the last time, like she was talking to me and you can tell on the video that like I didn't want to talk to her, it's just I was nervous. But this time I walked in, I literally said, "Hey girl, Ashley is my witness." I literally said, "Hey girl," and I talked to her about New York and I was so proud of her and stuff, and like we had a good convo going and security didn't rush me, so I love that. So my favorite meeting experience of this year was Miss Sabrina Carpenter. And then let's see, next question. Favorite album of 2018? Man of the Woods by Justin Timberlake. You guys, Man of the Woods is such a good album. You really have to sit down and like get in the zone and like listen to it top to bottom, no skips. Don't even skip the interlude. Like every little detail in that album is so important. And people call this Justin's worst album, and it's not his best. I think from the first album he put out to the most recent one, like that's the order, like it goes from best to like least best. I don't think he has a worst album. I think it just goes best to least best. It's a very different sound from his old music, but like anyone who knows me personally knows that since that album came out, I listened to it in the morning, first thing in the morning. I listened to it top to bottom on my way to work. I listened to it top to bottom. Every long trip I went on this year, I listened to it top to bottom. Like I never get tired of this album, and that's the one thing that's important to me of an album. I can never get tired of it. That means like it's amazing. So my favorite album of 2018 is Justin Timberlake. Let's just consider this like a Justin Timberlake fan video, because he's every question I bring him up. Artists people slept on in 2018. Well, I'll name five because I could go on forever. So the artists that people slept on this year were Sabrina Carpenter, Jake Miller, Bebe Rexha, Hailee Steinfeld, and Charlie Puth, for sure. Like, those are all artists. They all either put in an EP or an album. So everyone I just named, you should go listen to their most recent music and stop sleeping on them. Everybody wants artists to be the next, like, Madonna or the next Beyonce. Just let people be their own sound. Actually, I said Hailee and I have Hailee merch on. If you can see from the back. Anyways. But yeah, I think what people should start doing in 2019 is give these smaller artists a chance, because they're not gonna be like the people before them. People need to stop getting out of that mentality and just realize that these new artists are gonna have their own new sound and you need to give it a try. I'm not saying you're gonna like it, but like at least give it a try. Question is, if you could switch your life with any person, living or dead, who would it be or why? Well, if I could switch my life with any person living or dead, I would switch it with Jennifer Lopez, because that woman can literally do anything. She does not age. She's a bad ASSS woman. Anything she sets her mind to, she achieves it. So I would want to change my life with her because she's everything I aspire to be. And even though I want to be like her, I don't really think I could ever like achieve something that high. I won't doubt myself, but like being realistic. So if I could be her, then like everything she's done, like I would have done. Like I would just like want to know what it feels like to like be a boss woman, because I don't feel like that yet. And I don't know if I'll ever be like that, but like Jennifer Lopez is like my biggest woman inspiration. So of course, if I could change my life with anyone, hands down it would be Jennifer Lopez. Next, would you rather go to a Cardi or a Nicki concert? Cardi B, okay, period. That was so confusing, I'm sorry. I didn't ask why, but the reason why I would go to a Cardi concert is because I can like vibe to her raps better than Nicki. Nicki, I only mess with old Nicki. Cardi, it doesn't matter if she's a small feature, big feature, if it's her own song, I can vibe to anything Cardi. I love her story, I love how she came up. I've seen her at Jingle Ball, so I already know how the vibe of her shows are, and I promise you, 2019, if I could go to a solo Cardi B show, I will. So Cardi B all the way. Next question is, biggest dream for next year? My biggest dream for next year would be to like get a new job that will lead me in the right direction to a career in media, because right now I'm working at fast food and that really has nothing to do with what I want to be in life, although I really don't know what I want to be in life. I'm still figuring it out. So just make more money, I guess, and travel more. But traveling isn't really a dream because like I already going to see Ariana in New York, but maybe one more trip other than that. Maybe go back to Jingle Ball next year. That'd be two New York trips, so I'll try. But my biggest dream is to like better my, well, I don't have a career, but like to get a better job and go in the right direction career-wise. That's my dream for next year. And then the next question is, what's the worst thing that happened to you this year? I would say the worst thing that happened to me this year is letting my mental health go so low that I felt like life wasn't worth living. That's the worst thing that happened to me this year. And I really don't remember what got me out of that. I know my friends helped me, but I think there's something that happened in between that. I don't really know what it is, but I got out of it. I guess like I just snapped out of it, which I'm glad, because like then I wouldn't be here right now. The last question is, what's the one thing you're looking forward to in 2019? The one thing I'm looking forward to in 2019 is focusing on myself. Like this year I tried to, and I feel like I didn't focus on myself as much as I need to. Next year I'm really gonna take the time to like have those days where I make lists and make plans and set goals for myself and achieve them. I was just looking at my 2018 goals the other day and I didn't even accomplish 25% of my list. Next year I want to be able to achieve, I haven't made my 2019 goals, but I'm going to do it like probably tomorrow. And everything I put on that list, I want to next year, the same day next year, I want to be on here and show you guys that I achieve everything that I set my mind to. So that's what I'm looking forward to next year, doing me 365 days a year. So thank you guys for watching this Q&A. I hope you enjoyed it more than last year's, because I know like I'm not really good at Q&A's. I'm trying to get better, but like people don't ask me questions, so it's really hard. So I only do them if I get at least 7 to 8 questions. So thank you to everyone who sent me your questions. Thank you to everyone who's watched my videos all year long. If you have any tips, good advice, bad advice, anything you want to tell me, you can always comment on my socials or in my description, so you can always hit me up and be like, hey, I didn't like that you did this in your video, maybe you should try doing this instead. Or like, if I didn't trim something out that should have been trimmed, just let me know. I hope you guys had an amazing 2018, but if you didn't, 2019 will be better, I promise. And if it isn't, then 2020 it is. Love you guys. Happy New Year's.